set the wrong audio source for that, so you've got like 2 minutes of me talking to myself. Okay, so this is the right click menu. So when you right click on any object in the game, it will pop up this menu. What we've got here is the radial menu controller, and this allows us to turn buttons on and off. So if you're able to target an object, you can turn on that button. If you're able to land at an object and communicate with the object, those will come on. If it's possible to listen or use sensors on there, you can do that. If you hover over a button, it will then pop up a tooltip at the top, and each one is different. And then at the bottom there's a bit of information about the target and your range, current range to the target. These currently don't do anything, I've just got placeholder text in them. It's also possible to set the colour, so if you right click on a hostile target it will be red, and we can obviously change that to green if it's a friendly target, or probably like a grey, like sort of a greeny grey or whatever, bluish grey if it's a neutral target. So that's all configurable with the with the targets. I don't know if hostile should be orange actually, I mean I don't really like the red, but whatever. So what you do is when you hover over it will give you a tooltip. The top one sets targets, so it will start computing like a weapon solution. This one will move, like get your ship to plot a course to move close to an object. This will plot a course to orbit around the object. This will plot a course to land at the object. This one will plot an ISD jump to the object, so that will actually take you through the process of charging up the ISD drive, doing the actual warp jump to a distant target, and then discharging the ISD drive. So you've got quite a, they'll have like a, all of these will have like a confirmation box and options to set the options. Opening a comms channel will actually open a new window, which will have options for talking to NPCs, whether to sort of, tell them to surrender or ask them for random information, opening up a trading interface, that sort of stuff. Active sensor scan will power up your active sensors and ping the target, and some targets might find that as like an aggressive action, but that will basically allow you to gather lots of information about the target, but it'll also light you up like a Christmas tree because you're blasting radiation towards the target. Passive sensor listen will focus all your passive sensors on the target, so you can surreptitiously listen in on information and get information about a target without powering up your active sensors. So if you wanted to you've got a setup which is like a stealth optimized setup for your ship, you could then listen in to a distant enemy target and try to work out what sort of modules they have fitted. So there were these are all the kind of the rough options that are going to be available early on in the game. Later on, I'll probably modify this so there's like an options button, and then that will let you set have a range of different powers or options that you can use. But yeah, this is basically it to start with. What I've got at the moment is all of the on click events are linked up to a null object. So we'll have a quick look at that now. So This is the class for it. Most of it is just dealing with changing the colours of buttons and stuff, which is pretty boring. I think the main interesting part is this initiate event handlers. And what we're doing is we're passing in a button, a string for the tooltip, and then a Unity action, which will be some other method or function on another game object. So, for example, if we're sending in the move to. We're sending in the move to button, right? We set the tooltip to like move to as a string, and then the Unity action here will be the move to event on the the plot course event on the navigation controller. So we'll pass that in for the sort of the particular class we want to do. I think that will work. I might have to change that. That is just all crap that I copied off source Stack Overflow, I think. So the first thing we're doing is we're getting an event trigger. An event trigger is a special... go back here and pick one of the buttons. The event trigger is a special script that allows you to attach events to things. And you can see each of these buttons has an event trigger script attached to it. Right? So we're going to get the event trigger and call it trig. And we're doing that by just getting the button we passed in, getting the game object, and then grabbing the event trigger controller component. We're then creating some event trigger entries, and these are little structs that basically, or I think they're a class even, they're a class that holds all the information that lets you wire up an event to attach to a UI object. An event trigger can be attached to any UI thing, so you can attach it to an image, you can attach it to a string, whatever you like. So what we're doing is we're saying that we're creating an event trigger on an entry called onHover. We're setting its event ID to this event trigger type pointer enter, so it knows that we want to bind that to the onEnter onPointerEnter event. We've got onHover callback, which is the function to call when it happens, and we're adding a listener to that, and we're just passing in this lambda function here, which is basically saying get the onButtonHover function, which is further down, and we're passing in the button and the tooltip to that. We're doing exactly the same thing for the onLeave, except the only difference is we're setting the pointer, the event trigger type to pointer exit, and we're setting the passing in the onButtonLeave method. Oh, and for all of these, we're then saying in the event trigger delegates, we're adding the event entry. And then finally, if the action we've passed in isn't null, and you can see up here for all of these, I'm just passing in a null action at the moment because I don't have anything attached. We want to set the onClick event, so event trigger type pointer click. We're passing in the action delegate that we've passed in up here, and this just comes down as a delegate function, so we can use that type to pass in delegate functions later on. And then we're basically just adding adding this as the callback functions, to the callback events, and we're adding it to the delegates. So with this event trigger, we can now add loads of different types of events to a button. Whereas with the button, if I just do this, the button we passed in, the only one we can add is this onClick event by default. So you need an event trigger script to allow all of the other events. So that's pretty much that. What we've got down here, these are the delegates that I've been using to pass into that. So on hover just sets the tooltip, and on leave just sets the tooltip back to zero, to an empty string. So that's what we got. Okay, so this was a bit of an interesting one for me, because I've not really covered the event, like the event trigger stuff before. If you've got any questions, stick them in the comments, or check me out on Facebook. And thanks for watching. Hope this was educational, and I definitely learned something from doing this task. And probably the next thing I'm going to do on this is set up the animation, so when you right click it goes blump and like folds up and pops out and folds up nicely, which is also something I've never done before, so I'm going to do a little bit of reading and then I'm going to try doing that. So if you see that in the next video. Okay, rock on guys, and I'll see you next time. All right, bye.